If there are options that you would like to change in the software so that they always exist even when you open up different projects, you would do this in the Preferences panel. So to access the Preferences panel, go to the top menu and select Storyboard Pro, Preferences if you're using Mac, or Edit, Preferences if you're using Windows, to launch the Preferences window. So this is not to be confused with the Project Properties panel under the Storyboarding menu. So this panel actually houses all the preferences for a specific project, so the project that you're currently working in, but will change once again and reset to the defaults once you start a new project. However, what you're doing in the Preferences panel is setting the general rules for the software for every project that you open in the software. So I'm not going to go through all the options in every single tab that we see in the Preferences panel, but I'm just going to go through a few to give you an idea of what kind of things you can do. So let's start in the Color tab up here. And what you see here is how various colors in the software are defined. And specifically what we're going to look at is Scene Group Box Color 1 and Scene Group Box Color 2. So from the previous tutorials, I mentioned that scenes have alternating colors. So we go from dark, light, dark. So if you feel that these colors are not obvious enough and that you really want to see the difference between the scenes, what you can do is change these two colors. So we're going to start with the first one by just clicking on the swatch to bring up the select color window. And I'm going to select maybe something really obvious like a fluorescent green and click OK. And I'm going to do the same thing for scene group box color 2. I'm going to pick a fluorescent pink and click OK. And then I have to click on OK in the preferences panel in order to validate that choice. And now if we scroll across in the thumbnail view, it's very, very obvious when a scene changes. So let's go back to the preferences panel. And this time let's go to Global UI. So if any of you used to work in any of the older versions of Storyboard Pro, it didn't have this dark gray background. It actually had a lighter background. And if you preferred that, you can go back to that by unchecking Use Dark Style Sheet. And you can see in brackets right beside that it requires a relaunch. So I'm going to uncheck that, click OK. And then from the top menu, I'm going to go to Storyboard Pro, quit Storyboard Pro, or you could use the keyboard shortcut Command Q on Mac or Control Q on Windows. It asks me before if I'd like to save these changes, so I'm going to say save. And now let's go back and relaunch Storyboard Pro. Right away here, you can see that even the welcome screen has that lighter gray color. So I'm going to select the same project. And now you can see that this project takes on that lighter gray color. So before I show you the last preference that I'd like to show you, I'm just going to select this panel right here as it provides a better example. So because you have nothing to compare it to, you can't really tell, but the lines dividing the light and dark surfaces, as well as the black outlines around this character's face, are very smooth, and that's because they're anti-aliased. However, if we go back to the Preferences panel, and we go to the Advanced tab, and we look under Full Scene Anti-Aliasing, we realize this is because the Enable option has been checkmarked. Were it not checkmarked, and I'll press OK to validate that, all of a sudden you can see that the same lines that divided the light from shadow as well as the black outlines of this character's face take on a jagged appearance. You can see that they almost have these little steps all around them. So anti-aliasing provides a smoothing that looks nice, but in fact takes up a little bit extra processing from the software, so things behave perhaps slightly slower as a result. So if you find that your software is a bit sluggish, you can always disable that in order to get slightly faster results. You may have noticed that when we were beside that option, it actually says requires relaunch. This is only required if the full scene anti-aliasing was disabled when you launched the software. Then you would have to click Enable, click OK, and then relaunch the software. But because it was already enabled, you don't really have to do that in this particular case. And although I didn't go through all of the options and all of the preference tabs in the preference panel, it's good to know that that exists and where it exists in the software so that if you would ever like to change an option, at least you know where to go.